good day. My name is Peter, I work for FutureWater, and in the series Mastering Weep, I would like to discuss with you how to get results from Weep. And let me start with thanking the Stockholm Environment Institute and especially Jack Sieber for delivering this Weep model to the world. And material presented in this tutorial can also be found in the various Weep manuals. Once we've entered data into the model and we would like to get results, in most models you would press somewhere a run button, but in Weep it's very simple, you press the results button. And if you press the results button and the results are out of date, Weep will ask you whether it should recalculate everything. Of course, you would say yes. Once Weep has finalized its calculations, you get a screen that looks a little bit like this. Now, it can be a little bit confusing, or let me say overwhelming, because Weep offers so many options to get your results. But in this tutorial, I just want to mention some of the most important issues you have to remember. And in general, you would always start at the left and at the top of your screen and then go a little bit down. So first example is here at the left, you've got something which is chart, table and map. We are at the moment in chart. If you go to table, you get exactly the same results, but then in a table format. And if you get map, you get a kind of map which is showing in a very nice way where the water is flowing. Let's start at charts. So we begin normally with chart and then we go to the top where you can have various options to select what you want to see. At the moment we've got the water demand, and in this case we've got two demand sides which are shown here at the right, and you can see that the demand for agriculture clearly shows a seasonal, a monthly effect. And for the big city, it's more or less constant for every month. And at the bottom, of course, we see that this simulation was for 6 years, 2000 till up till 2005. As mentioned, we start at the top if we want to see another result. So we press this little icon here. And now again, a little bit confusing is in the beginning this tree, where in fact at the bottom you've got the main issues, the main outputs, demand output, supply and resources, water quality, financial, and even you can check the input data. And then once you've got this here, there is a submenu, which you see here. And remind, this is the same submenu as you can see here. Assuming we want to get something from the river and we would like to see the stream flow, we go to supply and resources, river, stream flow. So to summarize, there is the main menu at the bottom and the sub items are here. Now, as you might have noticed, something has changed in this graph. The water demand is not shown for agriculture and the big city, but for only one thing. And what do we see? For the reference scenario. Now, Weep is very much into scenarios. We will discuss that later. But if we want to go to all branches, because this has only one scenario, then again, we see agriculture, big city. If you want to see other scenarios, you can click here. If you want to select only some months, you can click here. If you want to see different branches, you can click here. If you want to change units, you can click here. And also very nice is that you can click, I want to see the annual totals, which are here, or I want to see the monthly average values, which are shown here. Okay, let's go to monthly averages. And now assume you are not so happy with this graph and you want to see some variations. Then you go here to the right. And here at the right, you've got all kinds of options. For example, the chart type, at the moment, it's a line, but you can show the same results as a bar or as an area, whatever you would like to see. I think I just go back to bar because that's a little bit better for this one. Of course, you can change the color scheme here. So there are all kinds of color schemes. And important is also you can say that you want to see the bar by side by side or whether you want to see it stacked. Just very nice of Veep is if you go over here with your mouse, the results of this particular bar can be seen here at the bottom. There are a lot of other features here. You can show it as a 3D graph. You can make the axes as logarithmic ones. So many options to play around. Going back to the top and showing the results as table. Again, you have here the numbers as tables. And again, you can say, I don't want to have the monthly averages, but I want to see all the averages. And there is a very nice button here, which is saying export table to Excel. So I will press this one. The table will be exported to Excel. And here the Excel sheet is automatically opened. And here you see the results. Exactly the same, of course. But this might be somewhat useful if you want to do further analysis. I go back to Veep. And let's start with charts, that's what we normally do. And let's go for some other options because we didn't explore what's here at the bottom. At the bottom, you can define whether you want to see all years or whether you want to select a couple of years. For example, if you're only interested in the year 2004, you select 2004 and you get only one particular year. Now, a little bit confusing in the beginning might be that this is not only for the time, but this is also changing. So if I say all branches here, I get the branches here. And here, instead of having the branches, I've got all scenarios. So again, if I go to all branches, it changes here, but also it changes here. So in the beginning, it's a little bit confusing. So please remind this on top is the main output. Here at the right, you can select branches or scenarios. And here at the bottom, you can select years or branches or scenarios, depending on what has been selected here at the right. And I think with this, I would like to stop. And in another tutorial, we go to the more advanced output creation of Veep. And with this, I really would like to thank you. Have a nice day. Hope seeing you soon in another tutorial.